Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
That's better. Before I speak about His Grace Vrindavan Chandra Prabhu, there have been two kinds of speakers that I'm a trainer, you know. For the last 18 years, I've been trained by a lot of people, and I've trained a lot of people. And there are two kinds of people that you usually hear. People you hear, and you get a very good night's sleep that night. And people you hear, who keep you awake the entire night. You just keep thinking, what did I hear? People who you hear and you forget, and people you hear who change you forever. In my life, you know, Vrindavan Chandra Prabhu has been one of those people who have actually helped me change my life for, I don't know how better, because it gets better every day. He was born in an army family, as a son of army father. He's not one of those typical pundits as you might have come across in your regular life. He's a person who has been trained in hotel management. He has led a hotel as a five-star general manager. He has been a president of a student union in his college. Since the age of 14, he realized that there's something beyond what we see as an obvious life. As we say, that eating, sleeping, mating, and protecting ourselves. And those questions led him to the quest of knowledge, which led him ultimately to read 48 different translations of Bhagavad Gita, until he stumbled upon a translation by Srila Prabhupada, the founder Acharya of ISKCON. And that he was so impressed by it that he took it as a mission of his life. About a couple of years back, he has formed his, he's dedicated himself after leaving his hotel and commercial life to this mission. And he has got his organization called as GIV, Gauranga Institute of Vedic Education, with the sole objective of imparting a knowledge of Srimad Bhagavad Gita to all the people, young people, old people alike, and help them lead life as per the principles of, that's given in Bhagavad Gita. Today, he believes that Bhagavad Gita is the, everything that comes in life, everything that's ever produced has a owner's manual to it. So similarly, for human beings, if there was ever a manual written by God, that's Bhagavad Gita. So I invite him now to speak certain words. Can I do this?
I'm a Rotarian of a sort, that my father was a Rotarian and my mother was the president of the Inner Wheel Club in Agra. So I've been involved in a lot of eye camps with the inner wheel when I was young, and with my father in the Rotary. So not new to the Rotarians. And today's topic, come down straight to it. We have got only half an hour. Though Bhagavad Gita is not something to be learned in half an hour, but then also it can be learned in half an hour. But today my interest will be that I want to inspire in you. What do I want to, after half an hour, what do I want you to do? Is I want to inspire you to actually read Bhagavad Gita. So the question is, why should you read Bhagavad Gita? Is it important? Has it got any relevance in your life? What age it should be read? It is something to be read early, in the early part of life, in the middle part of life, or in the later part of life. So the topic of today, I've turned it around a bit. It means the same. Manual for management of life is Bhagavad Gita, is in Bhagavad Gita. Because otherwise I have to start in the Urdu fashion. That is Bhagavad Gita Life Management Manual. So I would start in the Urdu fashion, start with manual. So first we start off, what does a manual do? We'll have a little interaction. It's not waste actually. We'll be using four or five minutes so that it'll not be only me speaking and me thinking. I want you also to be involved in the process of. So, what is the first thing When you read a manual, you get to know. With the premises that you do not know. For example, you get a machine, but you don't know what for what purpose it has been designed. So the manual, the first thing the manual teaches you is, what is its purpose? Right? First thing, because if you get a machine, a small chip, maybe, you see it, you don't know what it is. So what do? You go to the inventor or the creator, or the second aspect is? The manual. You go to the manual, plus the representative of the creator or the inventor, because he can pass on the knowledge. So manual is good, but you need the second person also in the middle, and that is the salesperson or the person who comes and installs that particular chip in your computer or in your mobile or anywhere else. He explains it. So the manual, first thing which we should understand is this, that a manual, I'm talking very generally, I'm not coming directly onto Bhagavad Gita, I'm just talking that the manual, first thing it tells you about is what is your goal. Now, we are all sitting here. We are all human beings. Right? So, if I ask you, simple goal of this, my watch, what is the goal of this watch? Absolutely right. Tells us the time. You know about it. How do you know about it? That it tells the time. Can you use it properly if you are not told about the usage? Like I was giving an example the other day, that if someone is given a grenade and he sees the grenade, does not know the purpose, he's been given a manual. What he does, he pulls out the pin. What is going to happen?
Explode.
So actually, you should know the purpose. It may be good or bad. In the war front, if you know how to use a grenade, it's very good. You put the pin, you pull the pin out, you throw the grenade. But if you do not know the purpose and you pull the pin out, you had it. So anything which has been designed. Now, I was talking about the watch. Okay. How do you know that this watch is for knowing the time? Because the person who first designed this watch actually has designed it to know the time.
So since that time, we are knowing the time from our watch. So now I ask you a question. You see this human form of life, you see this creation which is so perfect. You can predict the sunrise for tomorrow, for 2012, for 2030 to 3000. That means everything is moving very systematically, precisely. And when anything moves systematically and precisely, that means there is someone who has made it move in that way and seeing to it that it is still moving in that way. Because in an atomic clock also which has been designed, there is some loss of time. You have to reset it. Because the friction can be minimum but it can never be zero. Actually, science says zero is, you can think it should be zero, but it is never zero. So the first question which rises is, why was all this designed? Where do you come to know about it? From where? Is your not body a perfect, like you, today you got 20 megapixel camera, 100 megapixel camera. Now this, I was reading somewhere, it was 300 megapixel camera is also coming out. But have you thought about this camera? Hanji? Today 3D, 3D. Huh? But we have been 3D since generations. We have been 3D since generations. And we are glorifying those companies which are first time 3D.
I get a little shocked when first time. I mean, what were you? 2D? You have been 3D every time? Hey, Prabhuji? 1D, 2D or 3D?
7D.
Everything. So, there has to be some designer has to be there. And actually, the top scientists of the world believe that there is a designer. They believe. This is not the topic of the day. People like Newton, he spent 85% of his time in proving to the scientific world that God exists, and 15% of his time for his scientific experiments. This is proof, this is basically known knowledge today, that Newton, Louis Pasteur, was a theist. Einstein, he believed that there is some energy, some power, but actually that is not highest. There is energy, but there has to be energetic for the energy. You got intelligence, that is your energy, but you are the energetic. Without the energetic, there can be no energy. So let us forget at this juncture, let's forget the creator. And let us think that what is the goal of human life? The manual should tell us, but let us see, because you have, most of you here have crossed the threshold of 40 years, 45 years, and you're reaching, maybe accepting few of you who are still below that. What do you think is the goal of life? What do you think, Sukhiji? Supposed to link up. Yes?
Moksha. Peace. Freedom from this bodily.
Okay, I'll take it up. Let me take some answers first. Yes?
To become one with the procreation.
You to become one with the?
With the divine force.
Okay.
Procreation.
Procreation.
Procreation. Yeah. For your next
generation. Okay. Okay.
You have to perform that and then maybe die out. There is predefined work to be done by us. Being a system of.
If we follow that predestined work, what do we attain?
Happiness.
Who said that? Yes. Anyone else? The goal, I am talking of the goal. The goal never changes in life. Please understand one thing. I don't have time to explain on that. But I can tell you one thing. The goal in life never changes.
Quality life.
To live quality life. What do you get by living quality life?
It gives comfort.
What does comfort give you?
Fulfillment.
Yet fulfillment gives you what?
Satisfaction.
Satisfaction gives you what?
Happiness.
Right. I'm trying to take you to the goal. You are basically talking of the means. Satisfaction is a mean. Attaining something is a mean. Linking up with God is a mean. To do what you are predestined for is a mean. Because a terrorist also can say, I've been predestined to basically blow up people's heads. Sorry. Wrong. Because you do not know what you are predestined for. That is what the mistake mostly fanatics make. They think, I have been predestined to do this particular act of violence. Though that is not what he is predestined for. So ultimate goal is to be happy. Rest of all means lot of fame, name, money, lot of comforts, big house, big car, everything. But ultimately what do you want? You want happiness from that. That means the goal of every human being is one. It is not two. You don't have different goals who are sitting here or anywhere else. Every one of us have got the same goal. Why am I speaking? Because I get satisfaction. And by that satisfaction, I can be happy. So, every one of us actually should be selfish. Bhagavatam says, Vedas say, Swarth Gatim Hi Vishnu, Swarth Gati.
Swarth. Swarth. Sw means I. Arth means bhala. Benefit. What is benefit for me? Gati means the goal. Now the next part is how do you attain it? That is a different aspect altogether. But first we should be clear that what is our goal. You go and ask a student. He'll tell you the goal is I want to become CEO. I want to become something like Bill Gates. I want to become something like this. No, sorry, that's not your goal. That is actually your means. That means you're not clear about your goal. Because I speak in IITs and medical colleges, IIMs, and I found 99.99% people not clear about the goals. They basically think the means to be the goal. Actually, whatever you're doing in life and what you're thinking is actually the means. It is not the goal. The goal is happiness. Would you like to become the richest man in the world and be the most wretched person mentally? Would you like it? None of us sitting here or anyone in the world would like that. Actually, not us only. The trees also want to be happy. You grow a seedling in a place which is under the shade of another tree. That, what will happen to that small plant? It will start going towards the sunlight. Right? A dog feeling hot will look out for shade. Why? Is it looking out for comfort or is it looking out for happiness? It's looking out for happiness.
Comfort.
He thinks. Now comfort has got different levels, Babuji. Actually, we think comfort, you need happiness for comfort, but it actually is not. When you are happy, you are comfortable automatically. We move, what is happening today in society, what is happening, we are moving from outside to inside. Whereas we should move from inside to outside. Sukh Suvidha, you must have heard about these two words. Suvidha and Sukh, these are two words, they are never interconnected. Suvidha reduces your suffering, never gives you happiness. For example, you come into an air conditioned office, you are feeling very hot, you come into your office which is air conditioned. What happens, Prabhuji? You feel relief, but there is an income tax raid going on in your office. Bataiye, aap to Ashwin ji chartered accountant hai. You are comfortable? No, you are not. Yes, your suffering has reduced because of the heat which you were outside. Now your suffering has reduced, you have become more comfortable, but that comfort did not result in happiness. It basically reduced your suffering. That's all. So that is what is going on today is this, that we are thinking that I am happy, but actually that's not happiness. What is that? Prabhupada used to very nicely explain this. That's why in the beginning when I was going through this philosophy, he said very clearly, actually you are thinking that you are happy, but actually you are not happy. So then he gave a very nice example. The example is simple. When do you feel you are happy? When one of your problems are solved or one of your desires is fulfilled, right? But at that particular point of time, you have got a queue of problems. Have you got a queue of problems or not? Only one of those problems has been solved and one of your desires has been fulfilled. Not all of your desires have been fulfilled. Only one of those desires have been fulfilled. And you feel happy, but actually that's not happiness. That is just reduction of suffering. They say you have the fever, 106. You go and meet a person, how are you? Very bad state, Baba. And next day you go, he has 102 fever. How are you? Oh, good. You're not good. You still got 102 fever. You are basically relative. This is relativity. Now, what I am talking about is pure happiness. What is pure happiness? Pure happiness actually means that happiness which never finishes, first, and it grows. Whereas the happiness we derive when one problem is solved, like when I cleared my hotel management, oh, now look out for a job. Now look out for a, we used to have campus interviews, so they used to come for all chains coming in, oh. Same thing happens in your life or not? You get one contract, then running out the second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. So pure, that means that happiness came It was flickering, it went away, right? And actually this law of diminishing returns, law of diminishing returns also works in diminishing returns of happiness also. One gulab jamun, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10th, what happens? Hey, keep it away. Diminishing or not? It is diminishing. But what happiness we want, all of us want here, is that happiness should never end, right? And it should, what should it? It should grow. And that is actually the definition of Brahm. Brahmanand. You must have heard about this word. In India, the plus point is this, born in India, these words, if you don't want to hear also, you hear sometime or the other. That's why it is stated, to be born in India is great. Because these words will crop in. You don't want to keep your ears shut, then also chhoda khulte, you will get this Atma, Brahm. I don't want to hear about this, but then also you have to hear about it. The Brahmanand, this is something which is, you will say, is it possible? Yes. Please, we should not be like an Adivasi village person who has never seen a house which is above first story. If you tell him there is a building which is 100 stories, kya karega wo? What will he do? Hey, chhad poonch karao. He's gone mad. Right? He's gone crazy. Because he's never seen a building of more than ground floor. So this state is, and for this state you don't have to go to the jungle. Please understand one thing. Now I'm just explaining to you word, the word yoga in very short. Yoga means to link, to join. Do ka do se yog karo. Yog means to add, never to subtract. In your life also, remember, all of you are yogis. You say, I don't practice yoga of any kind. Nahi. So when you feel hungry, what do you add? Food. When you are in ignorance, what do you add? Knowledge. When you are not feeling well, what do you add? The doctor's advice. You can't maintain your accounts. Whom do you add? Ashuji. Catch hold of him. Hey, get my accounts right, Baba. Add him. So all of you are adding. That means you're yog in yog. Yog means to add. It comes from the word yuj. So all of you are adding. But the only problem is this, that we are also adding wrong things. You feel very thirsty, and without seeing the source, you will drink that water. You get typhoid. So ignorance led to suffering, and knowledge leads to happiness. So we clear about this point. Now we come to the next point. This is the manual telling you that what do you want? You want to be happy. That's what Arjuna actually is representing us. Arjuna says, by killing my kinsman, I will never be happy. I will never be happy. So that means I and he have got no difference. We of all of us and Arjuna have got no difference. He is fighting the battle on Kurukshetra, the battlefield of Kurukshetra. We are fighting our battle on our Kurukshetra. So there is no difference. Don't think it was spoken 5,000 years back, he had some different things going on in his mind. No. First of all, he also went through, first thing, tension. How should I, can I fight? Then depression. He was depressed. The Gandiv, the Dhanush fell, slipped from his hand. He sat down. That's what happens. What happens in depression? Your shoulders still. You become like this. He became like that. And then what did he do? Suicide. He said, let them come and kill me. I will not protect myself. In suicide, what do you do? That's what you do. That's what you do. So, is it different than today? No. That's what we are seeing in youngsters. During your school days, did you ever hear of suicide? I never heard. I am 56 years old now. I never heard. We never used to think of suicide. Aata tha man ke andar. Has it ever cropped into our? Never. We used to see. Huh? Never. What? Suicide? What is that? We had failures. Everyone was there. Still we used to be together. Joking. Theek hai yaar. Ho gaya. No problems. So now, how to manage? Now, what does manage mean? When you get a manual, you're told how to manage. Manage what? You got different, like for example, you got a latest washing machine. It's totally computerized. It also understands the heat which is outside, the powder which you're putting in, the weight, everything. It analyzes the chemicals also inside that powder. It's got all these functions. Why does it have all these functions? Why does it have all these functions? Because it can give you clean cloth, right? That is the goal of the washing machine. So what was our goal? Is to be happy. So we have got family life, we have to work, we have to do all these things. These are things, you got so many things. People start saying this only, अरे भगवत गीता करते रहेंगे तो हमको बाकी चीज कैसे करेंगे? अरे भगवत गीता करे बगैर तू बाकी चीज कैसे करेगा? How can you do other things without doing भगवत गीता, without knowing them, understanding the manual to manage the machine? How can you go ahead? You may start pressing the wrong buttons. It may state that these two buttons should never be pressed together, all your machine will conk off, and you do that only. And that's what happens in our life. We basically short circuit our life because we do not know how to manage our life, because everything has to be there. As I told you, yoga means to add, not to subtract. Please, by running away from life, that's what Arjuna was trying to do. By running away, that I'll run away and go into the jungle. Sorry, there is no jungle now. There are only concrete jungles. And at that time also, Arjuna basically was talking about going to the jungle. He was a Kshatriya. He was an administrator. He could not see wrong. If he saw wrong anywhere, that again that his blood would boil. So Krishna was telling him, if you become a monk also, if you see some wrong going on, then your that nature will come out. So everyone of us, according to our previous karmas, have been born with a particular nature. So you may be a businessman. Businessman, a person with a businessman's nature, a business nature, should be doing business. He should not join the police force. We call it dhanda, right? So if a person with a business mind goes and joins the police, what will he doing? He'll be doing dhanda. Anything wrong? Yes, wrong. So a round person in a square. So what is going to happen? His life is not going to be very cool. He's going to make his life a problem, and he's going to make others' life also a problem. That's why a person who's got a business mentality may be doing, just selling mumphali on the road is a better than a person who's got a business mentality and sitting as a police commissioner of Delhi. That is what actually seems. That is management. And that management we are almost finished. We have forgotten. You do not know. Now, last point. That is life, a very important point. Let's go back a little. I said knowledge gives happiness and ignorance gives suffering. Simple. Relationship with the wrong person, business with the wrong person, eating in the wrong place. All these things are what? Due to ignorance, they give you suffering. And if you know what is right and what is wrong, it gives you happiness because you act like that. So now we move ahead. First point. A person who gives most of his time or all of his time for things which are less important, is he called a knowledgeable person or a person in ignorance?
Ignorance.
Ignorance. Right? Will he be happy or will he suffer?
Suffer.
Suffer. Right? Now, I ask you a question. In the last 300 years, knowledge has increased or decreased?
Increased.
Absolutely right. I've got my laptop in front of me. The lights are there. Air condition is there. Right? But has happiness increased or tension increased?
Tension.
This does not match. Does it match? It does not match. Knowledge has gone up. Tension has gone up. Oh my God, what is this? I was just, we worked out a formula that knowledge gives happiness and ignorance gives suffering. But we all of us agreed to this particular point that knowledge has increased in the last 200-300 years, which we cannot deny. Then there's two things. First thing is this, this is not knowledge. But that we have already said that this is knowledge. We can't discard it. Second point is this, that this knowledge is incomplete. This knowledge is incomplete. Bhook lagi hai. I mostly give this example. You're feeling hungry. And you get a aadha kacha, aadha pakki roti. Half baked chapati. What will happen? When you eat it, you know, first thing what you'll do? And after 2 hours, right? Immediately it will give you satisfaction, you'll feel very nice. But after 2 hours, and that is what is happening today or not. Initially you feel very happy. But after some time, it becomes a cause of unhappiness. So that means, aadha kacha, aadha pakka means half baked. Half baked means there is something missing. Half means something missing. That means that part which is missing is actually the missing link to the goal of all of us's life, and that is happiness. That is the missing link. And what is that missing link? That missing link has to be knowledge only. Because gold can only be completed by gold. If there is a gold bangle, it can be completed by what? A gold bangle only. In the same way, knowledge gives happiness. If this is knowledge is not complete, that means the other part which is missing has also to be knowledge. Now what is that knowledge? Only three questions and you give me the answer and we will know what that knowledge is. Three questions. First question, simple question. What is more important, living body or dead body? Well, yes, more important is living body. Number two, what is common in both? Body, absolutely right. Living body, dead body, more important living body. Living body, dead body, what is common in both body? Third question, what makes the living body more important than the dead body? Give me a very simple answer.
Life.
Life, absolutely right. Life gives importance to the body. Now I ask you a question. How much time are you giving to understand the body and for body? How much time are you giving for the body and how much time are you giving for life? Tell me, how much time are you giving for the body?
Very situation specific.
Life, tell me, what is life?
You're giving all the time to life.
No, you're giving all the time to your body.
God has given an integrated system to protect and to maintain body.
Yes, yes. Maintenance, you're absolutely right. Maintenance of the body for what? What is life?
Quality life.
Quality
life. Better life.
Quality life. What is life? Life is different than the body. Please understand. In dead body, the body is there. But what is missing?
No life.
No life. That means life is a separate entity in itself, which is giving what is it is giving importance to the body. Simple example. Why? What is that life is different? I'll tell you in one answer, in one statement. And that statement is, you say this is my house. You are the house or you're different than the house? My car, the moment you say my, I am different than the car. When you say my house, that means you are not the house, you are different than your house. In the same, you say my body, that means you are different than your body. And that particle, which gives life, also known technically as consciousness, also known in general terms as jivan, life, is actually the energy of the soul, called in Bible as the soul, called in Quran as the Ruh, and called in the Vedic scriptures and the Eastern philosophy, different Eastern philosophies as Atma. Sanskrit word says Aham Brahm Asmi. Aham means I am the soul, not my soul. My soul is grammatically wrong. If I say I car, grammatically wrong. In the same way, when you say I soul, grammatically is right, I am the soul is right, my soul is wrong, because this body is yours, but you are not the body. Now, number two, when I say my house, my house is for me or I am for the house?
Me,
absolutely right. My car, the car is for me or I am for the car? The car is for me. When I say my body, that means the body is for me, I am not for the body. But actually the whole time we are spending is to understand the body, for the body. But how much time are we giving to understand the soul, who I am? What is happening today is this, we are accepting the soul or rejecting the soul without understanding it. So I request you all to please not accept it or reject it. without trying to dwell into it. And our whole life is gone in not trying to understand the more important thing. And that is what is happening in society today. And the Bhagavad Gita actually starts when Arjuna told Krishna that please tell me the way to happiness. I am confused. He used actually the word, very right word. He did not say I am not happy, because he knew the cause of his unhappiness was actually his confusion. In our life also, the cause of our unhappiness is actually confusion, which creates different type of things, which brings in the productivity goes down because confusion creates tension. We start thinking of the future instead of thinking of the present. That is thinking of the results and thinking of the effort. So all these things are coming in, and these are all explained in the Bhagavad Gita. That how, why? So when Arjuna asks this question, I am in confusion. Please remove my confusion and tell me what is right for me. What should I do? And that's what he said. Then Krishna tells him what, you know, he did not tell him anything else. He said, you are not this body, you are the soul. Because first understand the ABCD of life. And this study of life is known as spiritualism. And study of body and whatever time you spend on the body is known as religion. Please try to know the differentiation. Religion can be changed. Religion can be changed. It is a matter of faith. But life in, it may be a Muslim, Sikh, Christian, anywhere, is the same. So soul level, when you come onto the soul level, you never see a person by his bodily identification. That is called unity. That can only come when you come to the level of spirituality. That is real unity. Otherwise, what will happen? I still remember in 62, जब छोटा था, 6 साल का ही हूँगा, परंतु मुझे याद है, father गए थे वो लड़ाई करने के लिए, तो उस टाइम हिंदी चीनी भाई भाई, that's what they used to see, right Prabhu ji? पहले क्या हिंदी चीनी और फिर क्या भाई भाई, whereas it should be opposite, भाई भाई फिर हिंदी चीनी. If there are two sons, they are not first doctor and engineer, they are first brothers and then they are anything else. So this is what spirituality, if you want to bring unity into this, and this is not propagated. Veda means knowledge. Veda is not Hindu. Please understand. This word Hindu is no word at all. Hindu is a geographical term. Veda means knowledge. Veda translated into English means knowledge. It comes from the word with. With means to know. And Bhagavad Gita is actually the gist of Vedas. 94% Vedas are lost. Only 6% are available. So this Bhagavad Gita tells you who you are, why you are here, what you should do. It does not tell Arjuna to go into the jungle, not to do anything. It tells him to fight the war, but for what? So it is not important to study this. It tells, I'll end with this, it tells about five things. No knowledge is outside these five. First thing, I. Who am I? Jo aadmi apne aap ko bhul jata, the person who forgets himself is actually known to be mad. Sorry to say that, but it is a fact. What happens when a mad person? He forgets who he is. He starts acting in something which he is not. So that's why the first thing which Krishna created is first to come into the same platform. Come into the platform of sanity. And sanity means understand who you are. Who am I? First thing. Second thing. What is the absolute truth? Please understand. The Vedas don't talk of God as such. It first talks of absolute truth, which includes all the features. And one of the features is God, Bhagavan. People do not know the meaning of Bhagavan also. They say Bhagavan, Bhagavan, but Bhagavan kya hota hai, pata hi nahi. Bhag means opulences, Van means Vidyavan. Jo Vidya ko Van kare, wo Vidyavan, Dhanvan. Jo Dhan ko Van kare, wo Dhanvan. In the same way, Bhagavan, Bhag means opulences. There are six opulences, I don't go in detail, just trying to explain to you. Next point, third is talks about nature. There are two types of natures, the body nature, which is material, which finishes, and the nature of spirit, the spiritual nature, which never finishes, which is eternal. Third thing, time. Actually, you do not know time. No one knows time. It is very not an easy subject to understand, because time has to be understood by its value. Is it right or wrong? Time is the most valuable. So with this, you should try to get the most valuable. But what are we giving time for? To getting temporary things. Right or wrong, Prabhuji? Is it right? So let us balance life. And the fourth thing is karma. Karma means activities. activities of the body and activities of the soul. How to use the activities of the body to make the soul independent. Today this, we do not know the soul. So these five things the Bhagavad Gita talks about. And this knowledge is just like a lottery. Do you want the lottery to be, you should get a lottery at the age of 80 or at the age of 5? 5. Earlier the better. So in the same way, this knowledge also has been stated in the Shastras, that this is, this knowledge of the spirit is known as Vidya, and the knowledge of the body which you teach, you get college, education, everything, IIT also, is Avidya. It is called Avidya. That is why it does not give happiness on its own. The moment you link these two, not separately, please. You can't leave everything and go. No. When you have this body, you have to take care of the body. All the saints did that, but they did not give extra time for the body. They only gave as much time as it is necessary. Everyone did this. So soul, understand both side by side. What is wrong? And that is what is lacking in today's school education. Today what do they do? I was shocked when once some people came to me and told me, oh, this, my son goes to this school and it got, they were a psychiatrist. Oh my God, man, I will never send my son to this school. Because they make people, the students go through such a hell that they go, have to go to the psychiatrist. I never had a psychiatrist in my convent school, Prabhu. Is that a good school? Is it a good school which has a psychiatrist? Oh my God. What are they doing to the children? America, USA, 85% of their population visits the psychiatrist once in a lifetime, and 57% of them every 2 years, and people are so happy going and settling there. I do not know how 85% of Americans this go to a psychiatrist once in their lifetime. You talk to a gaawala, he'll say pagal khane ke paas gaya, pagal doctor ke paas jata hai kya, right? He'll say this. And 57% of them every 2 years they visit a psychiatrist. Not a healthy society, please. Understood? Totally material knowledge, very great material knowledge, but that buffer, spiritual, what is spiritual knowledge? Please try to understand. I'll just give you the last point because you asked this question. Spiritual knowledge does not change your world, but it changes the way you look at the world. Understand? Srishti nahi badalta, srishti ko dekhne ki drishti badalta hai. You cannot change the world, but you can change the way you look at the world. Does knowledge not do that? When you were not a doctor, you saw a person in a different perspective. But when you became a doctor, you start seeing him in a different perspective. Only what changes? That knowledge changes your way. So in the same way, I give an example, simple example. There's a road full of puddles. Ah, big holes are there. If you go in an auto, what will happen? Your spinal cord gone. Right? And if you go in a Merc or a BMW 700. Oh, you got the shockers. Suspension system. One goes down, the other keeps it on a level. So what happens? Do you change the road? You change your vehicle. So in the same way, when you take up the spiritual knowledge, you don't change the world, you change your vehicle. Ab bataiye, ghadde hai ya nahi hai, kya farak padta? What's the problem? So that is what Bhagavad Gita is all about. So that is what we have taken up in our life. Me and my wife. My wife is an LLM from Bombay University. She used to teach there. She has practiced in the Bombay High Court. So both of us have given our life for this. We have not left anything, please for understand. I've been a teacher. I saw my father in a uniform throughout his life. So to take this uniform was never difficult for me because this is my uniform. People say, oh, ye kya? And they never told my father when he used to wear OG. Hey, ye kya? Disrespect him. Oh, OG. Huh? Police commissioner wears his dress, or a DG wears his dress. You respect him. So that's why I never had this problem of changing dress. But dress does not matter. You don't have to become a policeman to become a good legal citizen, a lawful citizen of this country. Do you have to become a police wala or a lawyer? No, you can wear this dress and still be a law-abiding citizen of the country. The same way, sadhu does not mean going in the jungle. Sadhu means a person who obeys the laws of God. Simple. Thank you very much. If there are any questions, you can take any question. Yes.
Sir, one humble. Bhagavad Gita mein ek baat aaya hai ki
Sure, I'll explain. ट्राई टू एक्सप्लेन इट इन अ शॉर्ट वे, जबकि ये श्लोक अपने आप में मतलब आई एक्सप्लेन टू यू इन हिंदी बिकॉज दैट विल बी मोर, इंग्लिश में वर्ड्स इतने ज्यादा होते नहीं है, सो इट बिकम्स अ प्रॉब्लम. सो इंग्लिश इज एक्चुअली, वैसे भी फ्रेंच इज अ बेटर लैंग्वेज देन इंग्लिश टू इफ यू वॉन्ट टू प्रेजेंट योर सेल्फ, एंड संस्कृत इज द बेस्ट इन द वर्ल्ड. सो सर्वधर्मान परित्यज्या माम एकम शरणम रजा. ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड धर्म. धर्म में बस टू लेवल्स, एक होता सनातन धर्म, एक होता है जिसे कहते हैं हम अस्थाई धर्म. अस्थाई धर्म है कनेक्टेड किससे? बॉडी से. बॉडी के अनेक धर्म है. सनातन धर्म शरीर का है. भगवान कह रहे हैं तू अभी बताऊं क्या कर रहा है, अपने दिमाग से जितने धर्म पैदा कर रहा है उनको छोड़, और जो मैं आज्ञा दे रहा हूं उसको तू कर. तो अर्जुन को क्या कहा उन्होंने, तू क्या कर, तू गृहस्थ है, तू क्या कर, क्षत्रिय है, तू युद्ध कर. तो सर्वधर्मान प्रतिज्ञा फॉर यू मीन्स डोंट ट्राई टू यूज योर ओन इंटेलिजेंस, डू एज गॉड सेज. सर्वधर्मान, अपने मेंटल कॉन्ट्रक्शन को खत्म कर. टेक माई एडवाइस, लीड योर लाइफ. अब एडवाइस में सिंपल चीज है, अर्जुन को कहा कि तू युद्ध कर. ही वाज नॉट टेलिंग अर्जुना अब तू तीर उठा अब चला, नहीं, ही टोल्ड हिम यू फाइट. सो नाउ अकॉर्डिंग टू योर नेचर यू हैव बीन टोल्ड टू डू अ पर्टिकुलर थिंग. नाउ ट्राई टू डू दोज थिंग्स अकॉर्डिंग टू द शास्त्र. नाउ माम एकम शरणम रजा, सिर्फ मेरी शरण में आ जा. उसका मतलब ये हुआ, ओनली ओबे माई वर्ड्स, ओनली ओबे माई वर्ड्स, डोंट डू मेंटल कॉन्कॉक्शन. ज्यादातर मैंने रिलीजन में यही देखा है, स्पिरिचुअलिज्म में बात करते हुए, एक्चुअली स्पिरिचुअलिज्म तो मोस्टली लोग जानते ही नहीं है. जो योग भी आज है ये बेसिकली इट इज नॉट स्पिरिचुअलिज्म, इट इज फॉर बॉडी माइंड, बॉडी माइंड और मटीरियल. तो बेसिक फैक्ट ये है कि लोग यही कह जाते हैं कि मेरे ख्याल से स्पिरिचुअलिज्म ये है, मेरे ख्याल से ये है. तो भगवान कह रहे हैं ये ख्यालों को क्या कर, हटा दे, और अब मैं जो तुमसे कह रहा हूं वो तू कर. जैसे आर्मी के अंदर मुझे पता है फादर कहते थे, हमारे यहां तो वो मार मार के ठुड्डे मार के दिमाग को ढस कर देते हैं कि जो ऑर्डर मिले वो सिर्फ वही कर. माय सिस्टर यूज्ड टू आस्क मोस्ट ऑफ माय फादर्स फ्रेंड्स विजडम टूथ है, बोले नहीं है, वो आर्मी वालों के नहीं होता. जब भी डिसिप्लिन में अपना दिमाग लगाया वहीं गड़बड़ होगी. तो भगवान कहते हैं तू जहां अपना दिमाग लगाता है मैंने तुझे जो कहा है वो कर. एंड वंस यू रीड द भगवद गीता यू विल अंडरस्टैंड दैट ये तो सब करनी है, इट इज ईजी. एंड फॉर योर नॉलेज आई वाज जस्ट टॉकिंग टू दीपक जी, आई वाज टेलिंग हिम भगवद गीता इज वेरी इजी टू अंडरस्टैंड. आई डू सेमिनार्स ऑन दिस इन विच आई एक्सप्लेन द भगवद गीता एंड इट इज वेरी इजी प्रभु जी. आई वाज एज ही टोल्ड यू आई वाज नॉट बॉर्न अ पंडित. कॉन्वेंट स्कूल में पढ़ा था, होटल आयन करता, जैम सेशंस में जाता था. हाँ, अपने होटल यूनियन का मैं प्रेसिडेंट था, बोट क्लब पे रैली निकाली है, होटल मैनेजमेंट पूरे इंडिया के इंस्टीट्यूट्स अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर, आई गॉट देम ट्रांसफर्ड इनटू फ्रॉम एग्रीकल्चर टू मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ टूरिज्म. 340 एमपीज के साइन कराए, सब कुछ करी बदमाशियां. उसका मतलब मैं भी आप जैसा एक था, मैं भी सोचा करता था कि पैसे कमाऊंगा, परंतु मेरे को थोड़ा सा ये जरूर था कि मैं चाहता था कि कोई ट्रिक ऐसी नहीं है, बगैर ये जंजाल में फंसे फिर भी हैप्पी हो जाओ. अल्टीमेटली एंड ऑफ द डे क्या चाहते हो आप? तो मैंने सोचा कि आई वॉन्टेड टू डू समथिंग फॉर द सोसाइटी, तो मैंने ये लाइफ को लिया और कुछ नहीं है, आई हैव नॉट लेफ्ट एनीथिंग. तो ये सर्वधर्मान परित्यज्या माम एकम शरणम रजा, ये इसका मतलब है प्रभु. क्योंकि तू अपना दिमाग लगाएगा तो पाप करेगा. अगर मैं सोचूं कि लेफ्ट पे नहीं राइट पे चलूंगा आज गाड़ी चलाऊंगा, अपना दिमाग हो गया ना. गवर्नमेंट ने क्या कहा आपसे, अपना दिमाग बंद कर सिर्फ लेफ्ट पे चल. ये इसी तरह से भगवान कह रहे हैं कि अपना दिमाग हटा दे, अब तू मेरे कहने के अनुसार चल एंड देन सी योर लाइफ. बट फर्स्ट ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड, शरणम का एक ही मतलब था. सरेंडर का मतलब क्या होता है, वंस वन जनरल सरेंडर्स टू द अदर, ही ओबेज व्हाट द अदर जनरल सेज, द अदर किंग सेज. इन द सेम वे शरणम मींस टू डू. भगवान को मानने का मतलब सिंपल है कि जो वो कहते हैं वो हम करें, बस. देन यू विल नॉट सी एनी कॉन्फ्लिक्ट इन एनी ऑफ दी स्क्रिप्चर्स, इट मे बी कुरान, बाइबल, गुरु ग्रंथ साहिब, गीता. यू विल नॉट सी any conflict, you will not see any conflict. So that is what the meaning is. Is it clear?
Thank you.
Any other question or we should?
Just
yes.
You stress on the word knowledge.
Yeah.
Can you explain what really is the difference between knowledge and wisdom?
Yeah. See, the basic fact is this, it is called knowledge and wisdom is actually called jnanam vijnanam. So Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita says wisdom can only develop after you gather knowledge. Once you gather knowledge, you apply into your life. When you apply into your life, you experience those things. When you experience those things, that is wisdom. So knowledge when applied, now it should not be haphazard knowledge. That knowledge which has been given. Because the biggest mistake what we think when we become, we have very high intellects, we get into high intellects, we start intellectual speculation. And that is not allowed. Because, Mr. Youngsters say sometimes, when I go to colleges to preach, kya kuch give us something new. So I tell them one thing only. Meneka, your father used to eat food from the mouth? Yes. Meneka, your grandfather? He also used to eat from the mouth. Meneka, your great grandfather? He also. Meneka, badi purani cheez hai yaar, kuch nayi cheez kar. Let's eat from some other side. Not possible. In the same way, spiritual does not depend how you think. So experience, no, take knowledge, apply in your life, and you'll become wise. But if you take knowledge, not apply in your life, you will not be wise because you will not be experienced. So wisdom means application of knowledge. That is called realized knowledge. That is called vijnanam in the Vedas. Jnanam, vijnanam. So that is what wisdom means. And actually, I make this comment. I give lectures in corporates also. So I basically make this comment. Your success, actually, some way or the other, knowingly or unknowingly, you are following Bhagavad Gita. Knowingly or unknowingly, you are following this principle. Though kai baar bolte hain, jab batata hu ye, are ye to main aise kaise karta hu? Main to bataya to tha maine aapko. I told you. But unknowingly or knowingly, to be successful, actually, you are materially or anyway, you are following these principles. You are following. Because if your intention, your productivity will be very low, you cannot be successful. Aapne suna hi hoga interview. Warren ka kya kaha tha usne? Because I don't think future nahi sochta, abhi kara jo kara theek ho gaya. I don't think of tomorrow. That's why he can do speculation of this kind. Because a person who thinks aur kal kya hone wala, he can never speculate. And actually whole life for a businessman is speculation. And when he lives in now, he is more successful than he will live tomorrow. These are all principles of the Bhagavad Gita. Effort oriented. And today world has become result oriented. That's my problem. Goals should be set, but those goals should not be fruit. You should not connect your success with the goal. Connect your success with your effort. That is one principle which I am telling you of Bhagavad Gita. Every step you take, think I am successful. Finished. You are every time happy. Your productivity is highest. But you are thinking of the future. Kya hoga, kya hoga. Bas gaya. Finished. With this, I have taken a lot of your time. Thank you very much for letting me speak. Hare Krishna. Thank you. Thank you.